Step number three in the Unleashed process is called authenticity. Now, if you've been with your struggles for a long time, it can be really hard to see life beyond your current situation. And the longer they go on, the more they feel like a part of you. And if this goes on for long enough, you can actually end up identifying with your struggles. For example, I am overweight, I'm a binge eater, I'm an emotional eater, I am bulimic, I'm anorexic, whatever that may be. And this is when you can start to feel even more consumed by your struggles than ever before. And you start to live your life as that person with that identity. And despite all your efforts, all of your attempts to get better, you know, trying those quick fixes, any tips or tricks or hacks you may seem, you still feel stuck. You just don't know what to do. And in the end, you just resign yourself to the fact that this is the way my life's going to be now. And any hope or optimism gets crushed by your problems as you feel worse and worse about yourself, with your struggles becoming stronger and stronger until you just cannot see a way out. And you may even come to the point of you just do not know who you are anymore. And what I want you to consider is, very much like split personality, we have two parts to us involved in our struggles. We have our true self part. Now, this is the part which is your authentic self. It's the part that wants to get better. It's the part that wants to change and get their life back and be over all these problems for good. It's goal directed, it's positive, and it's on our side. And then we've got a second part. This is our food struggles part. This is the part that is causing us to hang on to our old ways. It keeps sabotaging us and holding us back. And the thing is, if we've been with our problems for a long time, this part can feel all consuming. It can actually even feel like that we only have one part of us and this is our problem part. It's the food issues part, because sometimes it can feel so loud and so strong and be taking full control over every single thing we do, whereas our true self part is just left in the background, totally squashed by our food issues part. But the thing is, she's still in there. She is still there, she has a voice. However, your food issues part is just running the show right now. Now, what I want you to consider is that what you pay attention to grows. You feed what you focus on. So like I said, if you've been struggling for a long time, all of your focus and your intention and your energy is probably being placed on trying to fight, distract, avoid, and struggle with your food issues part. Whereas I know that's what you're trying to avoid. And even if you're really trying to focus on getting away from that part, getting away from your problems, by focusing on it, inadvertently, you're actually adding fuel to the fire and strengthening this food issues part, making it louder, making it stronger, making it more controlling. Whereas we need to consider our true self part more and actually paying her some attention and feeding her with time, effort, and energy to make her grow stronger. Because the flip side of that is, what you fail to use, you lose. So if we're shifting our focus and our attention from our food issues part to our true self part, the more we do this, the weaker our food issues part will come over time, because it's not needed. What you fail to use, you lose. Now, the very first step in rediscovering and strengthening your authentic self is to start to recognize how your food issues part is talking to you. How loud is it? What language is it using? How often? What sort of sentences or phrases? And you may be surprised just how much it's controlling your mind. But the truth is, your authentic self, your true self part, she is still in there. She's just very quiet and she's just lost her voice. But this is only temporary. Now, we'll be back for our next video and step four of the Unleashed process. So please stay tuned.